Now, next is about the spread of Muhammad's reputation. When Muhammad revealed himself to be the messenger of God and he started preaching a new religion, then he came in opposition with the people who used to follow the existing religion. And Muslims soon faced opposition from the affluent Meccan people who used to be very rich because of the trade. And that's why there was a conflict between Muhammad and those merchants. And as a result, majority of people used to be the merchant and they did not believe in the Muhammad's philosophy. They thrown away Muhammad from Mecca. And Muhammad was forced to migrate with his follower to another base that is called Medina. So Mecca and Medina are the two important cities, two important places in the Islamic tradition. So Prophet Muhammad was asked to move from Mecca and he was forced to move from Mecca and he reached to Medina. That is very closing place or very nearby place of Mecca along with his follower in 622. And this travel from Mecca to Medina along with the follower is considered to be very important event in the history of Islam, because this journey is known by the name of Hijra and it is considered to be a turning point in the history of Islam. Why it is considered to be a turning point of Islam? Because this was the day when the beginning of Islamic calendar is done, and that is called as the Hijri calendar. So Islam's calendar is Hijri calendar. Let me write here. Hijri calendar. So Hijri word has come from Hijra. So this is the Islamic calendar which was started at that time when Prophet Muhammad migrated from Mecca to Medina, and this migration is called Hijra, and it started the beginning of Islamic calendar, that is Hijri calendar. And let me tell you something about the Hijri calendar. Hijri is the calendar which is a lunar based calendar, and it is 11 days shorter than the solar calendar which is being followed by the people today, that is solar calendar. But Hijri calendar, which is the Islamic calendar, it is 11 days shorter than the solar calendar because it is lunar based calendar. Ummah was converted into the wider community. Later on, other people also started becoming the member of Ummah, and they were mainly from the religion which used to be the polytheist earlier. So these polytheistic people converted to Islam. Some of them were convinced to convert to Islam, and many of them were forced to convert to Islam. So the community survived on the agriculture and arms. So arm tax, that is called zakat. So to get the financial resources to run the community of Ummah, they required some money, and that money or that finance used to come from the agriculture. The agriculture was also considerably good over there in Medina. And the arm tax, the tax which was collected by the people, that was known as the zakat. So these were the two sources of income to the community of the follower of Islam, that is called Ummah. And in this way they used to run their expenditure. But these are the meager resources through which a community could be organized. So they wanted to know some other ways and means through which they can get more resources. Now what they did after that, let's discuss. Then they started doing the expeditionary raids. Expeditionary raids was done by these people so that they can get more and more resources to run their community and to organize their community. Otherwise it would be disintegrated in case of the low income. So Prophet Muhammad organized expeditionary raids on other areas to get more and more resources. And after a series of battles between Mecca and Medina, Medina was led by Prophet Muhammad. Mecca was conquered by Prophet Muhammad, and he came back to Mecca after defeating the existing merchant of Mecca. Now he insisted conversion as sole criteria to increase the member of community. Ummah was still a very small community by that time because there were very less followers of Prophet Muhammad, and especially he was getting opposition in Mecca. So he adopted a new way to enlarge his community, and he asked his follower to convert the people from other religion to Islam. And mostly the Bedouin people, who used to be discriminated by the rich merchant of Makkah, they started joining to Islam by converting to the Islam. So they left their polytheistic religion and they started to be monotheistic, and they started joining the Islam. In this way, the follower of Islam started growing rapidly. They embraced whole of Arabia, and Medina became its administrative capital, and Makkah as religious center. Medina was still the administrative capital because Prophet Muhammad migrated from Makkah to Medina and administration was done from Medina. But Makkah was also very important. As a result, it was considered to be an important religious center where people used to come for a Hajj. Makkah did not lose its importance because it was considered an important religious center where people used to come for visiting the Makkah, that was called Hajj. So Makkah and Medina were the two important center of Islamic land at that time under the rule of Prophet Muhammad. The Kaaba, which was the central shrine at Makkah, was cleansed of idols, as Muslims were required to offer prayer while facing the shrine. Central shrine that I told you was a cube-like structure, and it was a rule which was laid down by Prophet Muhammad that while offering the prayer, their face should be towards that cube-like structure that is called Kaaba. So the Kaaba, which was adorned with different idols of gods and goddesses, because earlier there used to be polytheistic people, that was cleansed, that was removed from the Kaaba, and it was cleaned. And in this way, they started following a monotheistic religion, that was Islam, and Kaaba came under the control of Islam. Now it was no more related to other religion, rather it remained the property of one religion, that is Islam. Until date, Kaaba is the center of Islam.